Hey, I'm Jordan, and this is Knowledge of Living. What's more pleasant to your ears, a soft guitar chord or shattering glass? A nice soft bird chirping or an alarm? Why do some of these sounds feel so unpleasant or uncomfortable to our ears? Putting all psychological reasons aside, we can actually analyze these waves to determine the differences. As you can see, sounds that are more pleasant to our ears are more smooth and sinusoidal, whereas sounds that are unpleasant are sharp or square waves. So square waves are more bothersome to our ears than sine waves. That's the observation. Now, let's do an experiment. I'm gonna play two different sounds, one after another, and you tell me which one you find to be more annoying. You might wanna put on headphones so you can actually hear the sounds, though. Now, most people will find that the second noise is actually more pleasing to the ear. Let's look at these waveforms up close and see what the difference is. It appears that our hypothesis was right. The first sound I played was a square wave, whereas the second sound I played was actually a sine wave. So we figured out that square waves are more annoying than sine waves, but why are square waves annoying in general? Well, we could look at a square wave approximation using a multi-term Fourier expansion series. But that doesn't sound like very much fun. So to understand how square waves affect our ears, it's imperative we understand how sound waves affect our ears in general. When a normal sinusoidal wave propagates through the air, it fluctuates the air molecules and causes pressure changes. The crests of the wave are increased pressure and the troughs are decreased pressure. And this will cause the air molecules to vibrate in the air back and forth. The same effect can actually be observed on a guitar string. When you pluck the string, you can actually see the string vibrating back and forth. What this is doing is pushing and pulling the air around it, causing pressure changes and emitting sound waves. Our ears can actually pick up these sounds because our eardrums will actually vibrate with the sound waves. Now, this is for sinusoidal tones, but what happens if a square wave is traveling through the air? Square waves will actually switch between crests and troughs very rapidly. This causes the pressure change in the air to also be very rapid. This in turn will cause our eardrums to vibrate way more than we're comfortable with. It's that sharp corner of the square wave that causes the pressure change from high to low so fast that causes our eardrums just to vibrate out of control, and that's what causes us pain and annoyance. Our ears are meant to hear sounds like the human voice and nature and rolling waves on the beach, all sinusoidal. Only recently in audio technology has mankind been able to create these square waves. And this is exactly why square waves are used for alarms, because they're noticeably irritating. Now, don't worry too much about damaging your ears due to square waves, because the actual power carried in a wave has to do with the volume or amplitude of the wave. So as long as you're listening to a square wave that is rather low volume, you won't actually damage your ears too much. So I have to ask, what's your favorite sound? And what's your least favorite sound? Let me know in the comments section. And I bet you'll find that that sound that annoys you probably has a lot of sharp turns in it. Thanks for watching this video. And if you liked it, please thumbs up and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to see all my future videos. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment in the comment section and I'll be happy to answer. I'll see you all next week.